Welcome back to Evil Deedz part 12 of the Way campaign. Battle of Chibi. Completing all of the conditions will open the hypothetical route. That means this route here, bottom line. And that's the real timeline. So I'll be doing the hypothetical stage of it to show you. Okay, it's more better. And it's more interesting. The heroes fought bravely and controlled the battlefield, but they were unable to slay Yubi. In an effort to escape Cao Cao's reach, Yubi fled south down the Chengjiang. It was believed that he hoped to form an alliance with Sun Quan, who had solidified his power in Xinjiang. Furthermore, Cao Cao received information from Xi Shu, who had defected to his side. He told him from that Liu Bei had gained the services of the brilliant strategist known as the Sleeping Dragon Xu Geliang. Liu Bei and Xu Geliang, together with Sun Quan, who had a firm grip on the land of Xinjiang. If such foes were going to conspire against him, then Cao Cao would have little choice but to respond with him. Cao Cao formed a massive navy in an effort to seize Jing province from the discreet Yu Bei. Eager to defeat Yu Bei and Sun Quan, he advanced his fleet down the Chengqing to the area known as whatever. 1 year had proceeded since the Battle of Xixing. However, they were still Cao Cao, together with Xiao Shu, Shang Liao, and Yang Wei, advanced his mighty. What? You have me on.
Perceptive of him. knows exactly what they'll do. Intending to use fire, they are surely waiting for the very moment at which the winds change.
Surely not.
It is the role of the strategist to think of every possibility. You need not fear. I am sure that I will be able to turn this around.
Safe under the main battle, the real battle of it, you talk to Sal P, and if you're under the fake one, you talk to this guy, because Dion Wei and this guy shouldn't be here on the battlefield. They should be dead. Here the story will branch off on a different path depending on whether you speak with Chi Zhao or Sal P. Are you sure you wish to select Chao Chi? Yes. No matter which way the wind blows, it won't be a problem because we know what the enemy's plans are. The enemy has multi-yard plans for a fire attack. Let's unreveal that plan one piece at a time. I'll tell you exactly what to do when the time comes. Sorry, but this will take a lot of running around. But if we win here, the realm will be almost in our grasp. So let's get started.
This river shall be the end of Liu Bei and Sun Quan. Go forth, my elite troops, and seize me victory.
My lord, Sun Quan's men are attacking to the north under the cover of darkness.
Must be a distraction. Their real intention is to set our ships on fire.
Do not give chase to them. Fight only as required to protect our main camp.
Pang Tong's there.
Pang Tong, I knew this was your hand. I am impressed that you managed to meet so much.
Boom, boom.
The direction of the wind has changed. Board the ships to the east and intercept those enemy vessels. If we can cut out that section, we can prevent the loss of the entire fleet. Impressive. Just how is it that you managed to become so powerful?
Run aboard this ship and just wait. This is their fire attack.
Thank you. Mr. Tsai Ma. Another of our enemy's tricks, I'm sure. We should go and speak with him.
Defeating that person will give you a boost.
I enjoy just watching you out there.
So this is the ship. So now you have to wait here till everyone gets onto the boat. And then we attack and go to the and defeat Shang Liang. Shu Geliang. That's who it is. So much still coming. You can see on that map. It must be invisible, but I can't see it. If you do the other version, you're just running away and you're going to up that left side of the map to get away from them. Because all these plans, what you're stopping, they actually do work and there's nothing you can do about it. You be it as a peer. If you do the fake one first, it unlocks both of the levels anyway after. Instead of doing that level two times, but with different ways. You get battle unfolded, blah blah blah. The allies of Yubei and Sun Quan put up a stomach resistance against Cao Cao. However, the brilliant officers of Cao Cao's army were able to turn their threat aside. Impartially, the brilliance of the strategist Zhang Qi was we are equal. He managed to completely see through the plot of Yubi and Sun Quan. Or Sun Swan, whatever you want to call it. The numerous strategies he's prepared helped his officers overcome the disadvantages. As a result, Salsa's forces earned an impressive victory. Sun Quan withdrew his forces and Yubi followed soon after, escaping to Jiandong. Satisfied with the results of the battle, Salsa and his southern advance and withdrew. At last, they were no longer any obstacles of Salsa's path. Amidst their victory, the morale of Salsa and his men rose in anticipation of their eventually conquering of the land. Don't know how many officers are there though. There's about 10. Oh, 11. So let's see what the next one's gonna be. So the Battle of Tongit. Let's see what the next video. So if you enjoy, please leave a like, subscribe, or comment down below. If you want to, it's up to you. You don't have to if you don't want to. And in a bit.